Hi everybody, in this video we're going to review OMNET++. Specifically, we will learn how OMNET++ works and how NED and files and INI files work together. But first, let's review. So what is OMNET++? OMNET++ is an object-oriented modular discrete event network simulator framework. It has generic architecture so that it can be and has been used in various problem domains. Some of the domains that has been used for is modeling of wired and wireless communication networks, protocol modeling, modeling of queuing networks, modeling of processors, validating hardware architecture, evaluating performance aspects for complex software systems. In general, it's just modeling and simulation of any system where there's a discrete event approach that's suitable and can be conveniently mapped into entities communicating by exchanging messages. OMNET++ provides infrastructure and tools for writing simulations, and it's really not a simulator of anything concrete. OMNET++ simulations can run under various user interfaces. These user interfaces include graphical user interfaces, animating user interfaces, which are useful for demonstrating and debugging purposes. And then there is command line user interfaces, which are very useful for batch execution. So I mentioned that OMNET++ uses modeling. So how does modeling work in OMNET++? In OMNET++, models are assembled from reusable components, which are termed as modules. Well-written modules are truly reusable, and they can be combined in various ways. In OMNET++, a model consists of a module that communicates with message passing. The active modules are termed simple modules. So in this diagram here, I'm showing these are our simple modules, and these are written in C++ and they use the simulation class library. Simple models can be grouped into compound modules. This is our group for a compound module, and those can be grouped so on and so forth. There's a number of hierarchy levels and it's unlimited, but overall the entire module is called a network in OMNET++. The network itself is a compound module. So messages can be sent via connections that span modules or directly to other models. So let's look at how we can use modeling to describe the structure of a system. OMNET++ provides efficient tools for users to describe the structure of an actual system, and some of the main features are hierarchical models, module types, message, gates, links, modeling of packet transmissions, parameters, and topology description language. An OMNET++ model consists of a hierarchically nested modules, and they communicate by passing messages to each other. The OMNET models are often referred to as networks, and the top level module is the system module. The system contains submodules that can also contain submodules of themselves. As I mentioned before, the depth of this module nesting is unlimited. This module structure is described in OMNET++'s NED language, which we will go over further on in this video. The modules that contain our submodules, as we defined before, is called compound modules, as opposed to our simple modules at the lowest level of the module hierarchy. Simple modules contain the algorithms of the model. We, the user, implement the simple modules in C++ using our OMNET++ simulation class libraries. Then we have module types. Both simple and compound modules are instances of module types. When we are describing the model, we define the module type, and instances of module types serve as components for complex module types. All modules of a network are instantiated as submodules and sub-submodules of the system module. Go back to the picture that I showed earlier. These compound modules and these simple modules are all submodules of the network. Messages, gates, and links are used so that modules can communicate by exchanging messages. In an actual simulation, messages represent the frames or packets of in a computer network, or the jobs or customers in a queuing network or any other type of mobile entities. and messages can contain those arbitrary complex data structures. Simple modules send messages either directly to their destination or along a predefined path, which would be done through gates and connections. Gates are the input and output interfaces of modules, and messages are sent through output gates and arrive through input gates. And each connection, which also can be called a link, is created with single level of a module hierarchy. And within the compound one module, you can connect to corresponding gates of two submodules, or a gate of one submodule and a gate of a compound module. But because of our hierarchical structure of modules, messages typically travel through a series of connections, starting and arriving in our simple modules. So we kind of think of our compound modules as cardboard boxes for the module, and they transparently relay messages between their inner realm and the outside world. For using our modeling, we model packet transmissions. To facilitate the modeling of communication networks, connections can be used to model physical links. Connections support a bunch of different parameters, such as data rate, propagation delay, bit error rate, and packet error rate, and those can be disabled. And these parameters and the underlying algorithms are encapsulated into channel objects, and users can parameterize the channel types provided by OMNET++, and also we can create new ones. Modules can have parameters. Parameters can be assigned in either the NED file or a corresponding file in the OMNET PPINI file, which is our configuration file. Parameters can be used to customize simple module behavior and to parameterize a model's topology. Parameters can take string, numeric, or Boolean values, and they can contain XML data trees. Finally, the topology description language. So the user, which is us, defines the structure of a model in the NED language descriptions, which is NED stands for network description, which leads us to our next talking point. What is the NED language? So as I said before, NED stands for network description. We, the user, describe the structure of a simulation model in the NED language. And the NED language lets us declare simple models and connect and assemble them into our compound modules that we learned about earlier. We can then label some compound modules as networks, and that means that they are self-contained simulation models. Channels are another component type where the instances can also be used in compound modules. The NED language has several features which let it scale really well for our large projects. So one of the features is that it's hierarchical. In OMNET++, any module that's too complex as a single entity can be broken down into smaller modules, and then we use a compound module. It's component based, so simple modules and compound modules are inherently reusable, which means that we can reduce our code by copying, and more importantly, allows component libraries, which means that we're able to use our INET framework or Mixim or Castella or Veins, etc., to exist. There are interfaces. Module and channel interfaces can be used as placeholders, where normally you would have a module or a channel type, and then you could have a more concrete module that implements that interface that then gets substituted in. This is really useful. We use this a lot in our simulations. Then there is inheritance. Modules and channels can be subclassed, and then those derived modules can add new parameters and gates, which is also something that we use very often in our simulations. The NED language has features that are sort of Java-like. It has a package structure, and this reduces the risk of name clashes between different modules. This has a NED path, which is similar to the class path, and it's been introduced to make it easier to specify dependencies among simulation modules. There is also inner types. These are channel types and module types that are used locally by compound module and can be defined within the compound module in order to reduce namespace pollution. And then finally, we have metadata annotation. So it's possible to annotate modules or channel types, parameters or gates, and add different properties. Metadata is not used by the simulation kernel directly, but it can carry extra information for various tools and runtime environment. For example, the one that I use a lot is a module's graphical representation, which is like the icon. Then you can also have prompts for like measurement units as well for the parameter. And those are all metadata annotations. So we reviewed OMNET++ and the NED language. Let's now look at a working example. Let's look at our AODV example. In here, I have already opened the AODVnetwork.net. This defines our network. In the OMNET++ INI file, we are actually setting our network to AODV network. This is for the general option. Remember that you can have different configurations within OMNET++ on your INI file. And if you scroll down to some of our AODV examples, we actually changed the network. For example, on the config simple RRQ2, it changed the network to simple RRQ2. So it can be changed. But right now, on general, it's set to AODV network. Inside AODV network, we define several submodules. And each of these submodules actually can have their own submodules as well. So in AODV network, we have radio medium, configurator, routing table, scenario manager, and host, which has number of host for its size. Number of host is a parameter that actually gets set in our OMNET PPINI file. So in our OMNET PPINI file, we're setting the number of host to 20. This is how we're sending all these parameters. If you can see here, all these values that we are setting actually parameters within the either the AODV network file or its submodules. So let's go further and look at one of our submodules. So I am looking at AODV router, which is off of the host for our host files. So AODV router, if you wanted to, you can always right click and go to the decoration. In my case, I already have them open. So I'm going to AODV router. This extends ad hoc host. Within it, it has its own submodule. It has AODV as its submodule, and it also defines a connection. It defines AODV socket out to go to AT, which is the message dispatcher. If you hover over it, it says that it's the message dispatcher in plus. In plus is because AT.in is a vector. And the same idea with our socket in, it's getting AT out message dispatcher and it's going into AODV. So this is how it communicates. AT is the message dispatcher and AT is defined within ad hoc host. So ad hoc host extends wireless host. Here's some parameters set for ad hoc host and it has default values. If you didn't set these parameters, they would default to a specific value. You can do this as well within your NED file. So this ad hoc host, it extends wireless hosts. Wireless host extends standard hosts, which extends our application layer node base, which defines AT, the message dispatcher. So that is actually where AT lives. So now you can actually see how the hierarchy works, how we work with parameters with our NED files, and how connections are created within our NED files. The OMNET PPINI file sets our values for our parameters, but you can also have those default values as well on your parameters. So you just got a quick overview on OMNET++ and NED files and how they interact with our INI files. If you liked what you saw, please subscribe to my channel so you can get alerted for more OMNET++ tutorials and other random tutorials as well.